St. Matthew Passion by Bach.
Thank you. incredible. It's just phenomenal. Really very, very nice. There are a few things, I think, that I can suggest about the diction that will help project a different kind of color.
Mm-hmm.
That your color is very, very rich, and we were talking earlier about this piece and the use of vibrato, and how in a piece like this that is pleading for mercy, it's such a human experience that I need some kind of vibrato in that experience, in that human experience. And it was really, really beautiful how you managed to use it and then not use it in some moments when the harmonies really needed to be stronger and say something else. It's so liberating to sing Bach because there's so little micromanagement and there's so much information at the same time. I was just preparing the Harry Summers score. It is absolutely minutely micromanaged in every single way, and to hear Bach that just says, here's the music, here are the harmonies, here's the progression up and down and the dissonances, that's enough. And then he just kind of trusts the singer and the performer. It's wonderful. So in terms of the diction, when you say that first syllable, it is an invitation in a way. And if you say erbarme dich, it's different than erbarme dich, which has an openness that for a German speaker makes the word, it adds a meaning to it.
Mm-hmm.
Can you say that once?
Erbarme dich.
Yeah, you don't have to put any kind of inflection in it. Just the color of this vowel that goes erbarme dich.
Erbarme dich.
Yeah, and before, when you were singing it, because it's kind of low and it tends to get a little bit erbarme dich. So that's one comment.
Mm-hmm.
Rolling the R, very, very important. I mean, you can do that a little bit more. Those are the two main things in terms of the diction. Now, there's this figure, right? And like, what are these notes? Why isn't it just... What is in these notes? It's some kind of information that's not about the notes themselves, but is about the notes that follow it, right? Like a really meaningful like a portamento or something like that. So it was a little bit repetitive,
yeah.
This figure. It was always... or... always went up to the top note, and I would love to hear sometimes it, especially on some of the words. There's just always a kind of listening that you can do. If you have this figure, and Bach uses this figure in so many of his pieces, this approach to the minor third up on top. Anyway, let's start it one more time, and you will sing. Enjoy and have really a sense of welcoming your pleading for mercy. One other thing. This is pleading, right? Is a kind of energetic pleading. And then there is another kind of acceptance, when the melody kind of descends, that actually I think you can find kind of a sense where you can just be kind kind of subjugate yourself.
Okay.
So there's this sort of, you know, what we think of pleading in a an emotional way, and then there's pleading, just sort of waiting for it to happen. And those are the moments where the vocal line goes really low.
Okay.
Let's just see what happens.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. For me, the beginning doesn't need to be yet as strong.
Okay. Yes.
You know, it's the
yes.
first time that you say, "Have mercy."
Mm.
Oh no, there isn't the figure on it. Just, and I don't know if those markings in the orchestra are literally from the full score, but there's a pianissimo on this chord in this. So all that means to me as a performer is players listen to the voice, you know, and also a voice listen to the players. Okay? Courage, because it uses your breath, right? Meiner Seelenwillen. Yeah, it should really radiate through your body. Seelenwillen, like where is the soul, you know, in your body? Seelenwillen. I love how when you sustain one of those notes, I feel that you're listening. That's really, really beautiful. Are you going to roll the R?
Yes.
Okay. meine Zehrenwillen.
Yeah.
Yes, of course. Okay, you know what? Where do you sing Seele? Is it always Zehren? Okay, but.
That's another.
I'm not trying to make up for my mistake, but then it needs to be stronger.
Oh, yes.
Because it sounded like you said Zehren.
Oh.
Meiner Zehrenwillen.
Okay.
That. It needs to be a bit stronger. Here's a wonderful place where you can diminuendo. For me, is a really important kind of realization. Of course, it's all about the breath. And the breath is more than just, you know, ready to sing again. Because in the breath, you take in emotion through the breath. And if you invest in this kind of emotion going into you, then it's going to come out as well. It's a really important realization. And also the vowel. You can be ready a little bit in position of the vowel and then take the breath, for example, if it is erbarme, not neutral, and go erbarme, but erbarme, so that everything is in position, and as soon as the breath goes in and returns out, you're ready to sing in phonic. Okay, you want to start it one more time?
Yes.
Okay. The sound a little bit for your voice, but also actually a bit more than we need.
Exactly.
You know, it's kind of you're creating a crescendo by listening.
Okay.
And then at the end you kind of give it that little bit extra, which isn't, in my opinion, not really needed.
It's good news.
Yeah,
good news.
When I said less and more, I was maybe suggesting to you that this is, which is kind of mezzo piano to piano, and the other one is, you know, more on the bottom and even less on the top. You can do that. I wanted to say another thing with the long sustained notes. I don't know if this is a romantic approach, but music for me, regardless whether it is Baroque music or Strauss, it doesn't always have to be together. You know, for the chamber musicians who are sitting here, I hope I'm not going to get stoned. But with this kind of music, if your goal is to sing, sorry, my God, the music starts, it's all right sometimes to be a bit late in those notes, because they have to come from somewhere spontaneous, especially in a piece like this. Or when, if you sing Mozart, not so much the mezzo repertoire, but the soprano repertoire in Mozart operas, all those beautifully caressed high notes.
Mm-hmm.
If you try to, you know, place them up there, for me that's kind of missing a little bit on the style. So do you want to try it?
Mm-hmm.
And let's just do it. Do the first. Do the first. Yeah, where was it? Erbarme ich, my God. And then you can actually be a bit early on this. Yum. As opposed to ba ba bam, but yum ba ba ba. And then it will seem like you're late, but it's actually still together.
Perfect.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know where we are?
Yes.
Erbarme dich, mein Gott. different that you went to a different dynamic there,
yeah.
That it would have worked if it was approached a little bit softer at that moment, which I kind of expected. But that's the thing with Bach. He doesn't write Subito Pianissimo or anything like that. It's there's such faith, not just the faith that we all know about, but the faith in the music itself. It's incredible. You know what Zähren means?
Tears are running. Is it? A villain is running, but
it
my tears are...
Zähren are... It's something that has to do with a kind of a painful process. It's not just tears, but it's... If you have a time, if you're in prison and you get this much food each day, you tear on this to sustain you. So that's why this word needs to be stronger.
Okay.
Um meiner zähren Willen. There's a kind of, there's some kind of pain that you can express just by the enunciation of that word. Not by the comprehension necessarily, but just by how you enunciate it. You want to try it as we go on? Where were we? Let's pick it up where you play that. From this. Also, I know that there are a couple of German speakers here. Did you understand the words there? Yes? I wasn't convinced.
Okay.
if it was
okay.
Schaue hier was fine, schaue hier. But then Herz. Herz und Auge. Just
Auge.
I was exaggerating the glottal.
Okay.
Herz und Auge. As long as it's not Herz und Auge, yeah? So that bar can be, you come in on Schaue, and it really doesn't need to be...
Thank you.
of course, in German you can drop that final R if it's preceded by an E, but why do that in speaking? You know, when you sing, you want to sing with color, and what is more interesting, R or U? I always feel like I turn into a car salesman. But it's about color. It's not about correct or incorrect. It's finding as much color as possible. And also, technically, it's easier to support than right? That was gorgeous. Really, really gorgeous. When we have the repetitions of the words,
yes.
There isn't really a repetition musically like there is in some other songs, but find something to justify it. I mean, that's a big thing to say, the music justifies it already, but if you have... Just an example. Each time there is this, it's so soulful.
Mm.
If you can manage to not allow yourself to drift into a kind of neutral vocal dynamic, but control it.
Yes.
This is bel canto.
It's
control and connection to the words, and very few words that are repeated. It's absolutely bel canto. Where should we do it? Can you do it from? Just before the repetition of zehren.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Mein Herzen
erbarme dich.
A tiny thing. If you can, at the end of erbarme.
Meh. Yes.
Don't not to make it artificial, but the tendency is to Frenchify it a little bit, and then it's erbarme, and it's
meh.
It's a tiny thing.
Okay.
Do you know where to start? Suggests that there's going to be one, and then it's not complete somehow. But I'm always hunting quiniolas, whether it's Brahms. beautiful, Danielle.
Thank
gorgeous.
You. Thank you.
And John. Oh, thank you.
My name is Joel Allison, and tonight we'll be performing Se vuol ballare from Mozart's Le nozze di Figaro.
Bravo, signor padrone! Ora incomincio a capire il mistero e a vedere schietto tutto il vostro progetto. A Londra è vero, voi ministro, io corriero, e la Susanna, segreta ambasciatrice, non sarà, non sarà, Figaro il dice. Se vuol ballare, signor contino, se vuol ballare, signor contino, il chitarrino le suonerò, il chitarrino le suonerò, sì, le suonerò, sì, le suonerò. Se vuol venire nella mia scuola, la capriola le insegnerò. Se vuol venire nella mia scuola, la capriola le insegnerò, sì, le insegnerò, sì, le insegnerò. Saprò. Saprò, 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 ma piano, 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 piano. Meglio in arcano dissimulando scopir potrò. L'arte scrivendo, l'arte comprando, di cogendo, di non scherzando, tutte le macchine rovescerò, rovescerò. L'arte scrivendo, l'arte comprando, di cogendo, di non scherzando, tutte le macchine rovescerò, tutte le macchine rovescerò, tutte le macchine rovescerò, rovescerò, rovescerò. Se vuol ballare, signor contino, se vuol ballare, signor contino, il chitarrino le suonerò, il chitarrino le suonerò, sì, le suonerò, sì, le suonerò.
As a man, when we deal with emotions on stage, and quite often anger-driven emotions, it's very tricky sometimes, because those kind of emotions can become very overpowering, even if they're sort of, this is a small package of the emotions, it's not like second aria, the last aria,
yeah,
Act 4.
Yeah.
And it's always important to find the balance between where does the emotion start to affect the voice, and not so much the voice, but the intonation.
Yeah.
That's really what I'm trying to get at. I think you can focus a bit more on the intonation, and actually, in fact, it strengthens the character, because out of all the non-nobles in the opera, Figaro is perhaps the most noble in some ways, the most elegant, the most educated as well. So don't let it get out of hand when you're l'arte scadendo, l'arte brando, l'arte scadendo, l'arte brando, di camucendo, di da di da, tutte le macchine. Just keep it calculated.
Yeah.
Yeah. And that begins even with the recit.
Yeah.
This aria, it's so brilliant that in the aria, the first thing he calls the count is Contino, which is little count, like counting poo. maybe not as tenderly. So try to find, don't make it, this is the right word, acerbic.
Okay.
Continuo. But outdo him in elegance. Which, you know, if he were standing there to witness it, would be the most emasculating thing, in a sense, because you are so much more than he is, in some respects. I wanted to say two more things. So when you get to the aria, you sound it kind of really in fragments. Signor te volare, signor continuo.
Yeah.
I think actually, if you can sustain
mm-hmm.
this,
more deeper.
This name, well, even longer,
mm-hmm.
if you can sustain it, never ending, because this doesn't go. It doesn't go anywhere. It goes up a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
It stops without a cadence.
Mm-hmm.
Also another no cadence. Le suonerò, sì, le suonerò. There's a little bit of a cadence here in this. For the first time, so I would actually go there,
yeah.
But it gets interrupted immediately by nothing, right?
Yeah.
Just thoughts. And then you're back to something that's unresolved, no cadence. And even here, it's all C major, nothing.
Mm-hmm.
It's not, it doesn't, don't give it away yet.
Okay.
Until you get to. And then we have modulations and on almost every bar. Sapro, sapro, sapro. Let's see if we can delay it.
Sure.
From there. Okay.
Yeah.
When we get to it. There's a beautiful soft thing that happens under Susanna.
Mm-hmm.
The name Susanna. That sounded really. Ella Sus, can you play it? Ella Sus.
Okay.
I think it became too, all of a sudden, you were going to sing a 90-minute song cycle about Susanna
okay.
in the style of Schubert. It's just, es Susanna, because this music, it's her, but it's also her desire, her attraction to the count, which is real,
mm-hmm.
you know? So don't indulge too much.
Okay.
Let's start the rest.
Bravo. padrone. Ora incomincio a capire il mistero. E vede schietto tutto il vostro progetto.
Can you get to that point without stopping so many times?
Yeah.
Yeah. Also, it's not ora incomincio.
Yeah, ora.
Ora. Just one R. Mm-hmm. Bravo, signor padrone. It can be really overlap the ba ba bam bam ora incomincio a capire il mistero e vedere scritto tutto il vostro progetto. Anticipate the next entry and don't wait for it.
Sure.
The orchestra has commented.
Yeah.
And seven notes.
Bra.
Yes, sorry, from the top. Yeah.
Bravo, signor padrone. Ora incomincio a capire il mistero e a vedere schietto tutto il vostro progetto.
I'm after something that I think is important. I know you're extremely musical and you have great facility and range in your voice. It's fantastic. But you're stopping singing a little bit too soon.
Okay.
You're going, bravo signor padrone.
Okay.
Ora incomincio a capire.
Bravo, signor padrone, ora incomincio a capire il mistero.
Make that part of your strength.
Okay.
The fact that you sing recitatives.
Yeah.
I mean, there's lots of moments, you know, where it's where you have to convey information.
Yeah, yeah.
Right? Which is those recits that go like that.
Yeah.
But this is, it's not information, it's understanding.
Yeah.
So sing it really... With great vocal dedication, yeah? And be careful that it's not bravo. You can make a more noble sound.
Sure.
Bravo. Yeah?
Yeah.
Bravo, signor padrone. Ora incomincio a capire il mistero. E a vedere schietto tutto il vostro progetto.
Good.
Io corriero e la Susanna segreta ambasciatrice non sarà, non sarà. Figaro il dice.
Segreta ambasciatrice. What is it?
The secret ambassador.
Yes. To whom?
To the count.
To the count, right? You're still singing that segreta ambasciatrice as if she was your ambassador who's going with you to the room that you've been designing. E la Susanna di da di da 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 da. The count. Segreta ambasciatrice. Be careful that it's not non sarà, non sarà. Keep that sound nice and vertical, yeah?
Yeah.
Non sarà, non sarà. That's what I meant with the emotion at the beginning, that particularly males in opera in general, but in Mozart in particular, have to deal with, because there's always this kind of rage. Guglielmo, the Count, Don Giovanni, Leporello, all of them have this kind of expressed rage through the music, and it's really, really important to make it elegant rage.
Yeah.
Yeah? Just invented.
Allondra è vero, voi ministro, io corriero e la Susanna, segreta ambasciatrice, non sarà, non sarà, Figaro il dice. E vuol ballare, signor contino, se vuol ballare, signor contino, il chitarrino le suonerò, il chitarrino le suonerò, sì, le suonerò, sì, le suonerò.
Ask yourself, the beginning? Or, I mean, I'm in a judgmental way calling it, I'm calling it static. Maybe to you it isn't, but to me there's some...
I think it's sort of standoffish.
Yes.
That's sort of why he's written it. That's sort of my interpretation, is he's saying, okay, you want to dance? I'll play the ukulele for you.
That's very good. The only thing is the count isn't there.
Yeah.
And I think that's really important to not forget. Otherwise, of course, it would be se vuol ballare.
Yeah.
So I think there has to be more thought.
Mm-hmm.
Because I don't think the whole plan of what is your plan, which also fails in the opera, because it's a man, right? So it needs to come to fruition. And
yeah.
I think that the stillness of his music helps. And if you go, continue, if you invest so much emotion already, then you don't give yourself time to think.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just still.
Yeah.
But going 100 miles a second up here.
Yeah.
Not this still, but this needs to be still.
Okay.
Okay. And the music is still. Sing to them.
Se vuol ballare, signor continuo. Se vuol ballare, signor continuo.
This is so much more suspenseful already. It's really tricky because you're singing to him.
Yeah.
And we see on your face that you're imagining you're singing to him. But I would much rather see... I'm thinking. What am I going to do? You know, with this kind of hungry breath.
Okay.
Of course, the words are coming out. If you want to dance, count. If you want to dance, you will dance. We'll dance. I'll play the ukulele, as you said, right? But it's, you're not really addressing him,
right?
So allow yourself to think. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's all.
Se vuol ballare, signor continuo. Se vuol ballare, signor continuo.
You're still thinking.
Il chitarrino le suonerò. Il chitarrino le suonerò, sì. Le suonerò, sì. Le suonerò.
Dramaturgical sense. It's almost a bit too much contrast.
Okay.
There. You know, of course, the dynamics in the orchestra score are information for the singer. It's not always that they are the dynamics of the singer, but their information. That's the incredibly brilliant thing about Mozart. So this is bigger, of course, because it's higher in the voice and it's C major.
Se vuol venire nella mia scuola.
I wouldn't make that statement, nella mia scuola, too sort of evil, as if it's the school of evil doings.
Right, okay.
It's just, it's the answer to a question.
Okay.
In a sense.
Yeah.
You want to do it right on it? Se vuol.
Se vuol venire nella mia scuola, la capriola le insegnerò. sapro.
You have to be careful, that is not
sapro, sapro, sapro.
Don't cut that first note too short.
Okay. Sapro.
Yeah, even you need to phone it a bit longer there so that we really hear the pitch.
Yeah.
Start on a consonant.
Yeah.
I think it's important to think that you're taking this breath in the vowel.
Mm-hmm.
Ah.
Sa.
So that everything is ready.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sadro.
Yeah.
Sadro. Sadro. Sadro.
Just for an exercise, because it's hard.
Yeah.
Right? This is, that's a
yeah.
Seventh. Like that's a dissonant interval.
Yeah.
And this one is slightly less dissonant. This is a perfect, and then two perfect intervals. The top note, just if you had time,
yeah,
you would want to vibrate on it.
Yeah.
But you don't have time, but it needs to be really, really, it's like a pedal tone above.
Yeah, okay. Sapro, 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 na piano, 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 piano.
This is the first time as well. Very, very good. Very good. This needs a little bit more time.
Sure.
And how do you go on? With an informative breath, right?
Yeah.
Not just a... Yeah?
Yeah.
It's got to be a breath that means something. Yeah.
Meglio
niente.
L'arte che prendo, dico pungendo, di la scherzando, tutte le macchine rovescerò, rovescerò.
Artist! We're back in Rage City, right? L'arte sapendo, l'arte prendo. It's such a big temptation, and it's so dangerous for a performer, especially Figaro, that is such a huge role. And you're young. He's number three. Yeah.
L'arte servendo, l'arte.
L'arte.
Yeah.
Right? That's the key word. It's not lira tremendo, lira scacciando, lira. It's l'arte servendo, l'arte adoperando, l'arte facendo. Yeah?
Yeah.
Always return to the art. And it'll inform your Figaro in such an amazing way that, you know, I've been on stage with Figaros that are like, that own the role, and you really feel kind of confused, let's say, as a calm. You know, when there's a refined, elegant Figaro standing there that just has everything you want.
Right.
Including the girl. But that money can buy, he thinks. Okay. All right, let's go. Scoprire quattro. Also, there are no accents. It's not l'arte scrivendo, l'arte. That dotted look.
Yeah. L'arte scrivendo, l'arte coprando, dico pungendo, di la scherzando, tutte le macchine rovescerò, rovescerò. L'arte scrivendo, l'arte coprando, dico pungendo, di la scherzando, tutte le macchine rovescerò, tutte le macchine rovescerò. carino, le suonerò sì, le suonerò sì, le suonerò.
I love that supported consonant, right? If you enunciate exactly like you did, you don't have to worry about how am I going to support that vowel, because you're going the consonants support the singing most of the time. Excellent. There's one tiny thing. If you do that interpolation, which is really nice, make it something that means, again, that somehow shows your superiority.
Right.
And not just your musical taste.
Okay.
Okay? That's all. That's all. Bravo.
Donna Anna's aria Or Sai Chi L'Onore from Don Giovanni.
Oh!
really a consistent sound, and when you become emotional, your shoulders tend to create tension, and the tension, you know, it all goes through here. All tension somehow passes through this part of our anatomy at some point. So just be a little bit careful that it's okay to confront your audience and be open like this. First of all, you don't need to become angular.
Okay.
Sometimes on stage, but it's actually, it's from an audience perspective, it's so great to just see. That's who you are. That's who you are. Good. There are a few moments musically where I feel it's just you're wanting to, first of all, slow it down.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And those moments where the music stops abruptly, it kind of goes and it loses that kind of energy that goes through silence.
Okay.
To make this silence mean something, it again has to be a thought that happens there. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Let's try one once more from the beginning. There are also a couple of words, that if I can just. Ramenta. That M on there is really crucial. Ramenta, la piano, rira, di sangue. But ramenta, you say so many times that, as my Italian teacher used to say, a 15 N. So, another thing we all discover about Mozart is that some characters either completely or at some moments sing music of the past, I find. And especially in Don Giovanni Donna Elvira, her first aria is basically a Baroque piece of music, Pamina as well. And these characters, I always find, express a kind of purity in thought and purity and strength and emotion. And whenever I hear music that suggests that it's like a little tip of the hat to the Baroque era, is like these are my roots. This is what gives me strength. And there's a lot of it in this aria, not so much in the other aria, Non Media, but this one in particular. You know, when you're talking about your core value, and it's like Mozart writes, you know, Baroque music in quotation. especially for the women. But it's the melody really is sounds like it's angular. Right?
Mm-hmm.
But it's actually is in a very, very basic way.
Mm-hmm.
And if you make it even more angular, then it kind of takes a little bit of weight of the. This is still kind of placid. This doesn't change. Just find a bit more line in it and make us give the impression like you're singing an actual melody that doesn't have a major seventh leap in it. if you sing Fiordiligi or things like that, that's, you know, part of the art form, you know, that you suggest this note is up here and then it suddenly continues here, you know?
Yes.
Or so. Yeah, let's try to write on it. Do you need your note?
Rapi,
find a nice vertical space for that E?
Yes.
Rafi! It's actually, don't place it by thinking, okay, I'm gonna do the soprano trick. It comes from the consonant. It's there. Ra, right? The P is there. So if you're conscious of this P, then the I vowel just takes its place. Ra, pi, ra.
Okay.
You want to try it?
Yes.
Orso.
Orso.
What is that? It's something. What does it mean in terms of
emotionally?
Yeah.
I know that it shifts at that point. Mm-hmm. That she is less vengeful and more softened.
But just in pure basics, who are you talking about?
I'm talking about Don Giovanni.
Padre?
Oh, padre, yes.
Who's your padre?
My father, yes.
And where is he?
His dad.
Yeah. That's a kind of...
Oh, I see.
It's not him already. It's a where's Don Giovanni?
It's an emotion, right? It's you talk about your father, you're overwhelmed with... you've been sobbing, you know? Something to think about.
Yeah.
I still, if it can be more steady, then you can harness strength for yourself, but also give this character strength. I'm exaggerating it. Piano. Those are good things.
Okay.
So that means it's in the top of your range. It's Mozart wants it to be heard, but you're driving that volume there, and you're actually supplanting rage into a mode that can be strong. If you contain yourself a little bit. And what I meant, what I was trying to get after with this padre, is that you gave it a lot of sort of energy, let's call it. Padre! Like that. But you repeat this note, right? And there's something that you can find. Padre! If it was in slow motion. But there's a kind of new approach. It's not just ba-da-dee, then you might as well have written ba-ba, but it's
right.
A sixth interval, and then a repeated note up on top. So it's just saying, hey, find some relationship, maybe let's call it love, for at this moment, it's obviously more than just love for your father. But there's in that interval, you can find it. Can we try once more from the beginning?
Mm-hmm.
And don't, your voice is there and it speaks. It's so beautifully placed, and just trust it without thinking you have to drive the sound, yeah?
Yes.
Of a moment between ba and re, there's a thought that goes on. It's not necessarily exactly what I said, but ba, some transition. You want to do it right on it? Phrase, you don't put a little up. appoggiatura in between. And this. I'm just exaggerating, but especially the next phrase. Coperto, coperto, lido. Coperto, coperto, il terreno. Pa di da da di da da di da. Pure, really, really pure intonation. Mistakes.
Yes, sorry.
My left hand's not as good as my right. You can do something there.
Okay.
Right? It's a diminished. It can go anywhere.
Okay.
But you can do something there.
Okay.
You don't need to improvise something right now, but it can be quite strong. Not for vocal.
Frivolous.
Yes. Good word. All right, let's go from pure emotional piaga. Let's do just the cadence. So much to say.
Okay.
banal right now, but less is really, really
okay.
More.
Yes.
When you get back to the end, vendetta la
Strand, and we will be performing La Fleur que tu m'avais jetée from Carmen.
Oh.
especially at the end, it just became very intimate. And I think you allowed yourself to become intimate at the end by doing what's written. Because this couchette, it's pianissimo, right? He writes rallentando up to the B flat. And for every voice type, that means something different.
Mm-hmm.
But we need to know that this is where you're going, right? And it's so much about intention, music making,
mm-hmm.
that you really, really succeeded in that. Mm-hmm. Very, very beautiful. This character, right? Where does it come from, right? What happens to someone? Well, not necessarily what happens, actually, because you're already who you are.
Yeah.
It's not, you know, 30 years later, they meet outside a bull ring.
Yeah, right.
It's who you are now
mm-hmm.
who commits murder.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Not to sort of burden this aria with this kind of foreshadowing, because it's so sweet and innocent. But in your body, you're very elegant, and you stand in a very, you know, sort of placed kind of a way.
Yeah.
But what this character becomes is,
yeah,
you know, so find that kind of strength in your body from note one. And the music making is, you know, that's a conscious thing. Not a conscious thing, it's what's on the page,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
But you need your body to be engaged. La fleur que tu m'avais jeté. La fleur. And the diction,
mm-hmm.
you can bring incredible power and longing
mm-hmm.
into this aria through the diction alone.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You want to try that?
Yeah. Yeah.
Not louder, but
mm-hmm.
intense, and it means going from a kind of you know, elegant, beautiful man to being someone who wants to possess somebody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. This says it in all, right? Yeah. One more. This is how the aria starts, right? Da-da-dee-da-dee with those chords.
Yeah,
that's, you know, this is your omen. Your this is where you're going. Say, if you can breathe through your eyes as well, because
mm-hmm.
your musicality wants you to go, la fleur que tu m'avais, but it's like wide, eyes wide open, you know, if
yeah.
you can communicate
yeah.
that way, or if, then we see what you see, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
La fleur, and it doesn't really matter whether this fleur is here. It's actually better if it's don't you don't need
yeah.
a prop.
Yeah.
The prop is your imagination.
Yeah.
Just absorb.
La fleur que tu m'avais jetée dans ma prison terrestre, flétrissais-je cette fleur, gardée toujours sans douceur.
This is kind of eerie in a way, you know, your voice, it's so related not only to the breath but to the eyes.
Mm, yeah.
remember that.
Yeah, yeah.
You had a different quality in your voice through opening yourself through your eyes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
I'm gonna say it one more time. I don't know why, because it's so important.
Yeah.
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 Don't lose it, and trust that you don't. All we need to see is that you see and think.
Mm.
It doesn't need to be specific. You know, it's better sometimes if it isn't. If it's just that we see that you're thinking, and we see that you're imagining, and we see that you're living. Yeah?
Yeah, right. Yeah.
Without any kind of interpretation.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Okay.
Yeah. The opening was really, really gorgeous. Just one thing. Flittery, enjoy that sound. Flittery, sure. All that is there for you to use. It's your palate, right?
Yeah.
Every consonant should open your eyes wider.
Yeah.
Fleur que tu m'avais jeté dans ma prison. What did you sing there? Gardez toujours sa douce odeur.
Kept all the time its sweet odor.
But who is the flower?
The flower from Carmen.
From Carmen, yes.
Yeah, and it becomes.
So this is Don José speaking, right? Don't change. I want you to stay a sweet smelling flower.
Mm.
Right?
Yeah, yeah.
That's where the problem starts in a really big way. So it's not about, you know, there's intensity there. Do not change.
Mm. Yeah.
Yeah, and from the first moment, Carmen says, I change, right? From the very first moment, she's completely open. That way, but he doesn't believe it, okay? Let's do it one more time from the beginning and just feel the intensity in that. there's a line in, you know, our favorite opera, Peleas and Nerissov. What does he say? Oh. He says in the most seductive, beautiful way, he says, when he's engulfed by her hair and all of that, he said, no, tu es ma prisonnière cette nuit, you're my prisoner tonight, you know, which sounds all kind of, you know, one could say beautiful, but there's also something so disturbing about that, right? And like, instead of going, you're here, I'm here, it's will destroy you.
Yeah.
In a way, yeah?
Yeah.
All right.
Oh.
paupière. That is such a beautiful word.
Yeah.
Mais paupière, that you can use. And then this next phrase, can I challenge you to not breathe?
Des étoiles, je m'enivre.
I use that. All of those notes are there to help you ascend.
Mm.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And if you breathe, it's always a trade-off.
Mm.
You know,
yeah.
You're going to have more breath for the note. Because you have more breath, you might push. You know,
mm-hmm.
If you're thinking, okay, I have to conserve and be careful with my breath, it's always a good goal to set. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
But what's very important, je m'enivre.
Yeah.
That sound, if you can, because that's part of your support, right?
Mm-hmm.
Then you don't.
Yeah.
You can invest in supporting in the consonants. And not constantly on the poor little tiny teeny
mm-hmm.
vocal folds, right?
Yeah.
Don José is massive role in
mm-hmm.
the end. Okay, so all as much as you can invest in diction,
mm-hmm.
it protects your little tiny instrument.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Seems to be really long vowel, but just
okay.
A bigger a P. Okay?
Okay. Yeah.
Gesture or a thought or an emotion, but it has to be something.
Yeah.
It's a little undefined.
Mm.
Yeah?
Yeah.
But that phrase was fantastic, wasn't it? Generous and beautiful, and you stayed open, and
yeah.
You didn't you didn't hook up to that note
yeah.
either. It was just lyrical and really gorgeous. Let's pick it up from in all our it's on the word to right here. Dark, we have to open our eyes. La nuit.
La nuit, yeah.
Just
yeah.
use it as an excuse to keep your eyes open.
Yeah.
And not nuit. I want to see more in the night because it's dark. The space, I don't want to say size, because that's a different thing for voice, but the space that we feel in your voice when you go up to that register, it's really, really excellent. Use the Dardic rhythm. It's a crescendo there, even, using detesti. What I hear is morire. What I'm pretty sure, like when you sing this role, they want you to go a te morire, yada. Blaspheme. It needs exaggerated hyper diction. And he writes crescendo molto coming up.
Yeah.
It says a tempo on the downbeat, the that breath, right?
Mm.
That note has to come from the breath, not some note, but I'm going to see you again. I'm exaggerating an audible breath, which you don't necessarily need an audible breath,
mm-hmm.
but it's a breath that goes from A to B. Yeah. Sounded like I was trying to be mean, but I'm trying to show that you're drifting off
mm.
the pitch too much.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Like it's
yeah.
your last, like imagine this is a cello line and the cellist is like so glued to this pitch, it's like I'm not letting go. Totally in the core. Do you want to start it again from B?
Mm-hmm.
action creates more space in the back, yeah? Mm-hmm. Not your tongue.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Your tongue needs to stay forward because it tends to want to move back. Mm-hmm. But this hyper diction, if you invest in this kind of diction, then you can go anywhere you want with that note.
Mm.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Ah, toi. And then on Carmen, Carmen. It's a name, right?
Mm-hmm.
If you linger too much on that last syllable, Carmen, I don't quite buy it. And it's so simple the way he writes pian pianissimo, actually. He writes sempre pianissimo at the end. Carmen, Carmen.
Yeah.
Du liebes Kind, komm geh mit mir, Carmen.
That was a bit of Earl King.
You can find more than just Carmen is a pretty name. Yeah?
Yeah.
And it has to do with the breath, really. Don't forget about... I don't know. I've said it enough tonight, but you can... You have to. Not just that you can, but the way you breathe... The way you say Carmen, or there's so many different ways to say Carmen, mm-hmm. but it comes from the breath, right?
Mm. Yeah.
And then we don't even have to hear it. Okay. Try it one more time. To get into it, and then think each one of those hyper enunciated. Is creating more and more and more space.
Oh, my
in Act 4. And most of the time, by the time a conductor gets to Act 4, it's like... So, I'm just saying that not to diminish, diminish what the sincerity of this piece, but you have to be prepared to sing it a bit faster. Not just because it's in Act 4, but also it's got a bit more simplicity in it if it's a bit faster.
Okay.
Yeah. Very, very beautiful. Oh, can I just try something at the end? When you approach, I wanted to say at first as well, when you've got an aria with such a beautiful, beautiful introduction, and actually any aria, I would, all I need, and I'm speaking for everyone, let's see if that works, is to witness that you're listening to it. That can be the most powerful thing. That, because this this is a story. It's not just something to sort of fill time. It's something that you're listening to inside of yourself. So you don't need to fill it with anything else, but just, I hear something. It's always this sort of strange balance on stage. What is this music actually, you know? Is it inside of us, or is it outside of us? Kind of both, but some moments like this is really interior. Okay, let's just, I just want to hear the end for a second. Because what I hear vocally is, you've got a wonderful round space. And then, I'm exaggerating, please, that's not how you sounded. But you then sort of placed the high note.
Okay.
But you already, not you, but Mozart, gave you this in corona, in corona, no. It's all there already. Do you want to try it? From T. All of those need to be much more tapered. Giunse al fine il momento che godrò senza affanno in braccio all'idol mio.
Giunse al fine.
Good. This is pretty sprightly music.
Yeah, okay, so.
Bum,
giunse al fine il momento che godrò senza affanno in braccio all'idol mio.
Good. Be careful that there's an in braccio al.
Okay.
It's too, a bit too metric.
Yeah.
Try it one more time from this. You can almost start earlier.
Giunse al fine il momento che godrò.
Memento. Here's a crescendo for you. Where is that crescendo? Okay, well, the whole intro, please. Thanks.
experience it. This idea that it's not, you know, you're not building a Lego house, you know, where the pieces have to go only a certain way. The entries can be much more fluid and connected, yeah? Goes back to a little bit to the very first thing. Giunsi al fine il momento. There's a silence there. Giunsi al fine il momento. Which moment? Che godrò senza fondo in braccio il mio. Then the next interlude. Timidi cuore. Early.
Okay.
Not. Okay. Here comes my downbeat. There's another generic chord underneath, but it's a different kind of chord. Singing. But what is de? D-E-H.
It's like, we call that in English, like, it's a he, or...
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's not de, it's de. It's an invitation. It's like I mean, there's no literal translation of it, but it's a punctuation. Mm-hmm. It can be a bit more present. That's why Mozart goes really low for the soprano voice. I'm way too low. But really beautiful when you caress the. Really gorgeous. I'll do it from Finke non suggests there's a hymniola coming and then it doesn't complete. You can play with that there. There's a hymniola you can play with. Yeah? Right on it.
Oh.
just telling you, you don't need the appoggiatura there, the portamento.
Okay.
But it's optional. I think, like, portamenti down are always, they're much, much more rarefied than, you know, when we're going up to sort of take a bit more of the notes in between up for the ear, for my ear anyway, is much more natural. But going down is very, very special.
Okay.
And you can still do it in the aria, but I'm just telling you, it's not absolutely necessary.
Okay.
Yeah?
Let's try it again.
Okay. Close that vowel a little bit. I want to hear that one more time, just because it's so beautiful. Also, fronte can be a little bit more close. Not fronte, but fronte. I'm not wanting to put pressure on you because it's so really, really pretty what you're doing.
Let's do it again.
Just the right.
Starts Così fan tutte. More Mozart.
Ricomincio a combattere, ricomincio a combattere.
segno d'amistà. Ve lo mostro, ve lo mostro, vi do segno d'amistà, vi do segno d'amistà. Ma a tanti, a tanti, a tanti, a tanti, a tanti, la vi dice in verità, la vi dice in verità. Mille volte prendo presi, per salvare il vostro onor, mille volte, mille volte, mille volte vi difesi con la bocca più col cor, ma quel farla tanti e tanti a tanti e tanti, e inviziedo seccator, e inviziedo seccator. Siete vaghe, siete amabili, io tesori il ciel vi die, e le grazie vi circondano dalla testa sino ai piedi, dalla testa sino ai piedi. Ma la faglia tanti a tanti e tanti e tanti, che credibile non è, che credibile non è. Io vuo bene il sesso vostro, ve lo mostro il gran tesoro in ciò di te, sino ai piedi, gran tesoro in ciel vi die. Tanti e tanti a tanti, la fate e tanti a tanti a tanti e tanti. Che se gridano gli amanti, hanno certo un gran perché, un gran perché. Ma la fate a tanti e tanti, che se gridano gli amanti, hanno certo un gran perché, un gran perché. Perché, perché, perché un certo un gran perché. Perché, perché, perché un certo un gran perché, un gran perché, un gran perché, hanno certo un gran perché.
Das ist eine Schmeiß-Arie. Not to say the other word, but in German, if you schmeiß something, it's an accident that happens. And it's a really tricky aria. And it's definitely happened to me before in this aria. So bravo, really well done. Okay. Needs to be more instrumental, more pure, more pure. You're going too far with the danti, 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 ba ba bi ba bi ba 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 ba. Those notes are there for a reason, right? It's the word, the diction that connects it. Tanti, 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 tanti. But you can't, in my opinion, it's going too far, sort of drifting. It almost sounds like Alban Berg if you drift so much off pitch. Mm-hmm. And also, when not only Mozart, but composers use C major in a very deliberate way. And when they write something in C major, it needs to be pure. There's just something that says, okay, I'm giving it to you. Mille volte prendo presi, pa pa pi pa 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 pa. It's instrumental, right? It's okay. Trombone, something like that. Of course, there's the intensity of the text, but the whole thing. Let's try it one more time with that in mind. Yeah.
Sure.
Also, then you'll sing it a bit
more with a bit more bravura. Yeah,
okay.
If you just commit yourself to the just to the pitches. Much better already. Much better. Still,
yeah.
A little bit of unclarity.
Yeah.
Sort of, you're diluting it.
Kay.
You're diluting the power of this. This aria, do you know where it is in the opera?
It's like near the end.
It's near the end.
Yeah.
But it's just
after the both betrayals.
After the you're trying to actually diffuse a duel, let's say, you know,
yeah.
with Ferrando, you know, you've just successfully seduced his girlfriend, and he is absolutely destroyed. You know, Ferrando really, really experiences this betrayal. You know, of course, he's trying to betray at the same time. It's so so fake, but also so real. How everyone experiences, and so there's been this really dangerous recitative beforehand where it almost comes to a physical confrontation,
mm-hmm.
and you're diffusing it with this,
yeah.
hey, but all women are like that, did you
yeah.
not know that? You and you and you, you know, it can be really picky. I love you, dog. but it is really, that's about the character, you
mm-hmm.
know, about, this isn't Mozart. Of course, Mozart and Da Ponte are having a chuckle, you know, but as much as Mozart is able to create a chauvinistic character like this, he's able to create a countess, right?
Mm-hmm.
He can do it all, in a sense. So, very, very strong diction, and don't forget, you know, very often in this aria, Ferrando is on stage.
Mm.
Sometimes they solve the problem by him storming off, but there's no reason in the score that says Ferrando exits. He is really intended to be there. Hang on, what's, you have a recital there?
Just
yeah.
Ferrando
goes, Barba, ingrata, giorno, il pocore! He's devastated, and he goes, certo, questo grare, or whatever it is. Raffa, don't get so upset. Don't get so upset, because you want to get out of there, right?
Yeah.
It's a little bit like, le tanti cui vadano from Don Giovanni when he meets Mazzetto, and he says, let's distract from this dangerous situation.
Yeah.
And here, there, and then before you know it, he's gone, right?
Yeah.
It's very, very similar. And then Ferrando has, what's the aria right afterwards? Tradito, scarnito.
He's still upset.
Yeah, he stays there. He doesn't leave and come back. Okay. Let's do it. Tanti. Of course not literally to do that, but this is how I feel a consonant has to travel through a body. Tanti, donne. Because there's energy down there, right? In the ground there's so much more energy than from above. Okay? Li
comincio a combattere, li comincio a combattere.
You're a sword. No, like I gave you a kind of resistance.
Yeah.
And that's not the same as pushing. Like,
no.
That's supporting.
Yeah.
Yeah. Pushing happens when you sing vowels in a muscular way. But this is supported communicative singing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So if you can try that without without the chair, and just really find your up, that's it. That's it. You know, this kind of connection. But let's go on. That breath, where does that ego come from?
Io!
Right? If you go, and then you have to suddenly go, Io! It's a big transition, so.
Yeah.
Okay?
Io va bene il sesso vostro. Io va bene se so vostro.
Yes.
Lo sapete, ogni lo sa, ogni giorno ve lo mostro, ve lo mostro, ve lo mostro, ve lo segno d'amistà.
Mostro.
Ve lo mostro.
Sì.
Non lo so, vi do segno d'amistà, ve lo segno d'amistà. Ma quel farà tanti, 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 tanti.
Pure.
Ma quel farla tanti e tanti e tanti e tanti
tanti e tanti e tanti e tanti e tanti. I don't know if that's the right spot. Yeah.
Ma quel farla tanti e tanti e tanti e tanti.
Yes, bravo.
E un vizietto seccator. E un vizietto seccator. Mille volte avranno preso.
It's a repeated note for a reason. Okay? Let's once more C major. Okay?
Mille volte brando presi.
What's that vowel?
Well, which
mille. It's a little bit too neutral. Me,
oh.
Mi, mille, mille. It has a bit more closure, I think, than
okay.
you're giving it.
Mille volte prendo presi per salvare il vostro onor. Mille volte.
One more time. Because this, we're not going in the right direction at the moment. Because I'm feeling you're throwing yourself at the vowels.
Mille volte. Mille volte prendo presi. Brando presi. Per.
Right? That's also rooted, even though
mm-hmm.
it's over in a fraction of a second. But not per. Not on the vowel. That's dangerous and it can tire you out very quickly.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Mille volte brando presi.
No, you just need to train your ear a little bit more. Because it just sounds messy, and you can't be messy in C major.
Okay.
Mi la di da di da di da.
He's saying, you know, you're glorifying yourself. You know,
yeah.
Thousands of times I have fought against the tide, like il brando presi. So it's grand, yeah. And if you go ba 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 ba. Then it's weak.
Right.
Yeah? Right on it.
Mille volte il brano presi per salvare il vostro amor. Mille volte. Mille volte. Mille volte vi difesi con la bocca tuo corpo.
tanti, a tanti, a tanti.
No, I'm sorry.
I got lazy.
I'm sorry. It's so interesting.
Because actually that worked really well before. Try us the mille volte.
Yeah.
But feel it, because you're very musical, and you communicate a lot, but it lives here up, and not here, like really get your feet. Mille, mille. And feel it all through your legs, and your strength, and your core. Yeah? Mille volte il brano presi.
Good, that was really good.
Not to make you tense, but just to feel that the energy comes from below.
Mille volte il brano presi.
Let's go on.
Per salvare il vostro amor, mille volte. Mille volte.
Volte.
Mille volte vi difesi con la bocca più col cuor. Ma quel farla è tanti e tanti a tanti e tanti. Mi acclisce in verità, ma finisce in verità. Siete vaghe, siete amabili, più tesori il ciel vi die, e le grazie vi circondano dalla testa sino ai piedi. Dalla testa sino ai piedi, ma quel farla è tanti e tanti a tanti e tanti.
Good.
È invidibile, non è, è credibile, non è. Io vo bene al sesso vostro,
vero vostro. That's much better. That's much better. It's just getting a little bit slow now.
Yeah.
But you want to try it from? You know what? This is really something that you can reflect when the orchestra does. Not with the portamento, but with the same. E le grazie vi circondano. It's like you've suddenly got another someone in the orchestra who is on your side.
Great.
Maybe write on that. E le grazie. Just write on this.
E le grazie vi circondano. Dalla testa sino ai piedi, dalla testa sino ai piedi. Ma quel farà tanti e tanti a tanti e tanti. Credibile non è, che credibile non è. Io fo bene il sesso vostro, ve lo mostro mille volte a brando presi. Mi difesi quel tesori c'è mi die, sino ai piedi. Ma lo fate tanti e tanti, a tanti e tanti.
That's such a habit that you've learned, that you really does not sound the way you imagine it sounds.
Yeah.
It just sounds, pardon for this frankness, but it just sounds messy.
Yeah.
And it's a repeated word that something happens in while it goes down into this different range. Ma la fate a tanti e tanti, a tanti e tanti e tanti, la fate a tanti e tanti, a tanti e tanti. It really needs a kind of purity,
yeah,
and strength. It just sounds weak, and it sounds like you didn't learn the notes, but I know you did.
Mm-hmm.
It's just a habit that has become sort of, maybe it's more confrontational. You know, you can go, everyone's like that. Everyone's like that. That's kind of, tanti, tanti, tanti. But this is like, everyone is like that. Ma fatia tanti, 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 tanti. That's why it needs the kind of, it's an accusatory repetition. Yeah? It's
sprite just from... we're almost there. We're almost there.
Io
bene a se
sole.
Io vo bene. Io vo bene a se sesso vostro. Yeah.
Io vo bene a sesso vostro. Il nostro canto è solito.
Un gran perché, a non c'è un gran perché.